We're now fortunate to have a number of different myeloma therapies available for us in the relapse setting. The NHS approved pathway is incredibly complex, but does have a number of different proteasome inhibitors and IMiDs available, and more recently, daratumumab, which has been approved in the fourth line setting. What I was talking about is how best to use the available treatments and the evidence that underpins it. What I showed was the ability to give ixazomib in combination with lenalidomide and dexamethasone to patients, which allow them to continue with treatment for long term with having minimal impact upon their normal day-to-day living. I also demonstrated a case of a patient who had been treated with a number of different lines of therapy and went on to receive daratumumab monotherapy. She was an elderly patient and had an infusion-related reaction, but nevertheless has achieved a partial response and goes on and continues to have a durable response. And finally, I alluded to some of the new and exciting immunotherapies which are coming through. Namely, I talked about the first in human trial of a BCMA-targeted antibody drug conjugate, which is able to derive deep and durable responses for heavily treated patients with a monotherapy response rate of 60%. And also the promise of future immunotherapies such as CAR T cells, which are able to target BCMA.